A few days from today, the long-awaited non-aligned movement and G77 plus China summit will commence in Kampala. According to the government, all is set for the summits that will take place between 15th and 23rd January. The head of communications on the NAM and G77 task force and KCCA spokesperson Daniel Muhumuza Niwabine disclosed that they have made several revisions to the transport system in the city, but mainly targeting Boda Boda riders.
The objective of this operation is one, to manage and restrict Boda Boda congestion, to improve security and safety, to increase street visibility for pedestrians and motorists, since most of the stages have been blocking pedestrian ways and motorists' turn-offs, especially at junctions.
As a result, dozens of Boda Boda stages have been removed in Makindi and Central Divisions to pave way for the transportation of a delegate. Those affected include stages along the Parliamentary Avenue and neighbouring streets or roads leading to Munyonyo, among others.
In Makindi Division, the following roads, we do not expect any Boda Boda stage there, and they are not going to be there. One, Lukuli Road, Hanlon Road, Mobutu Road, part of Namasole Road, Wavamuno Road, Gaba Road, Mbogo Road, Press House Road, Prince Badu Kakungulu Road, Lukuli Link, Muyenga Road, and Mbogo Road. There will be no stages there. We have removed 190 stages in total on those roads in Makindye Division.
Unfortunately, the same traffic flow guidelines will be maintained even after the summits, as KCCA strives to decongest the city as well as enforcing the Boda Boda free zones. According to KCCA, only 25,946 Boda Bodas will be allowed to operate in the city out of over 37,000 Boda Bodas currently operating.
We expect not more than 10 Boda Boda bikes at each of the stages that I'm going to mention. And these stages are going to be 1 kilometer apart. The total number of motorbikes per stage at any one given time across the city shall be 25,946. The proposed riders in the whole city currently stands at 51,893. This is because riders usually alternate in 8-hour shifts.
Those rearing animals in the city have also been cautioned.
We are confiscating stray animals. These are eating the flowers, they are feeding on the trees that we have planted, and a menace to traffic as well as hygiene of the citizenry and residents of Kampala. Once we confiscate them, we take them to Lufula, where their owners can come to pick them and either take them out of the city to farms or pay a fine and have them slaughtered.
During the same period, a number of traffic diversions and delays will be enforced, as the traffic police spokesperson explained.
At Mpala, traffic will be diverted to Entebbe Highway. At Kisubi, traffic will be diverted to Nakawuku Road and access Kampala City. At Kajansi Flyover, traffic will be diverted to use Kajansi Flyover to Rubowa, then to Zana. There will be diversions also at Serena Chigo Traffic Lights, Mutungo Chitiko Traffic Lights, and Busabala.
Meanwhile, police have deployed heavily in the city, along the summit routes, the conference center, and neighboring areas. Standby fire and rescue teams have also been deployed in the priority areas.
Civil aviation firefighters will work with us, together with our team from Entebbe Fire and Rescue Service, based at Entebbe Division. We shall have an active team at Kajansi. We shall have an active team at the venue, which is the Speaker Resort Munyonyo.
Been working hard to ensure everyone is safe and secure. We have put in place a comprehensive security arrangement that considers several dimensions ranging from airport security, deployment at all traffic routes, marine security at Entebbe International Airport and Munyonyo, management of convoys, access controls, close protection.
At least 4,000 delegates are expected to participate in these global summits that will run between 15th and 23rd January 2024. Rachel Nachwala, reporting for the news.